you ever going to be another character besides Marceline in Adventure Time, or no?
Well, when I originally auditioned for it, it was Princess Bubblegum Lines, but I think they just kind of had that as a guide. But Pendleton actually sought me out because he sort of liked my vibe of the character I played on Phineas and Ferb, and he's like, that's what I want for Marceline. So I think I was always going to be Marceline. Not really a PB.
Okay. And did he ever approach you about like Bravest Warriors or any of his other stuff?
No, not yet. Maybe someday. I hope you're listening, Penn.
Do you have fun being Marceline?
Yes.
Best question ever.
Hi. Okay, so I don't really have a question. I just like being the center of attention. Actually, when I was younger, I remember seeing Vanessa Doofenshmirtz and thinking, goals, right there. So, do you have fun playing Vanessa? Is she a fun character to portray?
Yes.
Yes, one word.
No, it is. That was the first time I ever did any sort of voice acting, so it was very new to me, but it was definitely a world that I don't want to stop being in.
All right, thank you so much.
Hi.
Hello.
Can you sing a song about Marceline?
What song do you want to hear? A song about Marceline or one of Marceline's?
Yeah, exactly. Sorry.
I was like, I'm going to have to make something up.
Just your problem from the gate episode.
La da 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 da, I'm gonna bury you in the ground. La da 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 da, I'm gonna bury you with my sound. Gonna drink the red from your pretty pink face. Marceline, that's so distasteful. Sorry, I don't treat you like a goddess. Is that what you want me to do? Sorry, I don't treat you like you're perfect, like all your little loyal subjects do. Sorry, I'm not made of sugar. Am I not sweet enough for you? Is that why you always avoid me? Must be such an inconvenience to you. Well, I'm just your problem. I'm just your problem. Thanks.
Thank you. What's your favorite scene, and what was the most difficult scene that you've ever had to record?
I think my favorite scenes are any time that Hunson's in the episode, because my real-life dad plays Hunson Aberdeer, so it's really fun to get to act with him. I think the most difficult was definitely the first time Marceline turned into a demon. I had no idea that she was half demon at all, or that I was going to have to go there. I thought I was just going to do my same angsty little voice that I always do, and that's not really the case with Marceline. So it was very challenging, but now it's fun because I just get to go wild, but the first time I was like really scared.
If you had to change something about Marceline, what would it be?
Nothing's wrong with her. Maybe I would make her skin not so blue so I could cosplay her without having to put all that makeup on.
Hi. I was wondering, how does having characters who perform music add to you interpreting them as an actor?
That's a really good question. I haven't really thought of that. Well, I definitely only got into voice acting because I could sing. I never kind of sought out the career. It just sort of flourished through my singing voice. So every character I've played obviously sing, so it really is letting me kind of put myself into it more. So that's what I'm comfortable doing with is singing, not so much voice acting in the beginning of it. So that's what I like.
Thank you.
That was a really good question. That was deep.
Hi. I actually had a similar question, so now I'm kind of stumped.
Oh, but no.
I know. Actually, I was going to ask, I mean, since you do both singing and acting, which one you actually prefer to do? Like, do you enjoy it more when you get to do, like, voice roles or, like, singing roles? Or what do you have more fun with?
It's kind of, okay, it's weird because singing, hands down, that's, like, my passion, but I actually don't like when I have to do the songs for the show, if that makes any sense, because it's just kind of a whole different environment. We all record together. So usually we do the entire episode and then at the end we'll do the song, and that's after like a giant fight sequence where I've been screaming for an hour and a half. So then I'm like, I always try to ask them, I'm like, you guys, let me do the song first so I can be all like fresh. But I definitely like singing more than acting because it just didn't come as instantly to me.
Okay. And a follow-up, I kind of already told you that I kind of wanted to request a song since you're here. But the one that you did for Steven Universe, the I'm Too Famous, I'd love to hear you do that now.
Yeah. You warned me.
I know, right? I gave you a heads up so you can be ready.
I can't help it if I make a scene, stepping out of my hot pink limousine. I'm turning heads and I'm stopping traffic. When I point, they scream, and when I joke, they laugh. I've got a pair of eyes that they're getting lost in. They're hypnotized by my way of walking. I got them something like a stage magician. When I pose, they scream, and when I joke, they listen well. Everybody needs a friend, and I've got you, and you, and you. So many, I can't even name them. Can you blame me? I'm too famous. Haven't you noticed I'm a star? I'm coming into view as the world is turning. Haven't you noticed I made it this far? Now everyone can see me burning. Now everyone can see me burning. I think I got most of the words.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hello.
It's great to just, like, hear you. Like, I picture Marceline, and it's fantastic, so.
Right, I told you, close your eyes.
Yeah, you just close your eyes, and it's there. I just wanted to get your opinion on what you think of the way Adventure Time has evolved since season one to now, like, the direction that it's going in. Like, obviously without saying too much, what are your thoughts on it? How do you feel about it?
That's so funny. I actually had someone come up to me and was like, I used to love Adventure Time, and then it got super weird, so I don't watch it anymore. But in a way, I kind of felt the opposite from that distressed person. In the beginning, you know, I never knew where Marceline's character was going to go, so I had a different outlook when I was playing her. I thought she was just kind of this, like, antagonistic, kind of like funny bully character a little bit, who liked to push people's buttons. But the show started to get super deep after the first season. So I love it. I mean, I think that children's television should be doing more things like that and not dumbing down, you know, the broadcasting. So, and hey, the whole storyline with Marceline and her backstory like completely changed how I see the character, how I play her. I know that she's very troubled now, so yeah, it just makes all the difference when you really get to know your character like that.
Thanks. And just to follow up with that, how do you feel about the progression of the relationship between Marceline and PB?
I mean, I don't really see that much of a progression with them. I don't know. They're kind of just, if the show goes there, they'll go there, but who knows? I don't write it, so it's kind of hard to say.
Cool.
Yeah.
Well, thank you.
What do you think about voice acting?
I think it's awesome. What do you think about voice acting?
I think it's pretty cool that you could get a character from the real world and then voice them from the animated world.
Is there a real Marceline out there? I'd like to meet her. Are there any real Marcelines here?
Probably.
No.
Thank you.
Yeah.
If you could be any other character from the series of Adventure Time, who would you be?
I really want to play somebody evil. Maybe Peppermint Butler. I think he's actually like the darkest character out there.
What about the Leech?
Nah, the Leech is, he's vanquished. He's out of there. Who would you play?
I would like to play Cake.
Cake?
Yes, he's my favorite.
She's cute.
Well, thank you.
Hello, hi.
Hello.
I wanted to find out what your favorite movie is, and if Marceline had a favorite movie, what would Marceline's favorite movie be?
Oh, man. I don't really have like a all-time favorite movie. I guess the movie that I've watched the most times on repeat is Mean Girls. I literally know every line to that movie. Like, I could recite it from start to finish. I think Marceline would be into, like, 80s rom-coms. Like, anything, like, I don't know. Maybe some, like, Molly Ringwald.
Like 16 Candles. Yeah.
Pretty in Pink and all that. Thank you.
So I hear from my friends that I'm pretty good at voices, and I thought I'd like to do voice acting. Where do you think would be a good place to start with that?
Well, since I kind of got into it, like I said earlier, sort of accidentally, I don't really know the starting point, but me wanting to do more voice acting and going out for other roles and challenging myself to do voices, my bosses from Phineas and Ferb told me you have to make a reel and put it online. So really just master, you know, 5 to 10 really good solid voices that you have, record it, put some music behind it, make it snazzy, and put it online and see if you can take, you know, voice acting classes too is really a big help.
And when you're doing your characters, do you feel the emotions they do during the show? Like, the script says, do you have those same emotions as they're portrayed?
I mean, it is acting, so I don't really feel deeply what she's feeling, but you do have to thrust your entire, you know, body and mind into how the character would react. I did, however, when I was writing the Marcy Super Secret Scrapbook, that was kind of how I felt so connected to her. I basically wrote her diary as Marceline, so that was kind of crazy. I was like, well, how would she feel? Well, how do I feel? And, you know, finding the medium between the two, and it totally connected. I'm like, I am Marceline now, you know?
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you.
The other guy, he asked what your favorite movie was. What's your, like, what's your favorite TV show other than Adventure Time?
yeah, Adventure Time. I watch a lot of Netflix, so I'm sure we all do. I think, I don't know, I'm really into American Horror Story right now. And I love Pretty Little Liars. That's like my guilty pleasure. I'm kind of like a web sleuth, and I like look up conspiracy theories. Well, now that they exposed A, I was kind of mad about that, but okay. PLL.
Thank you. Good evening.
Good evening.
Yeah, I got a couple of questions. First off, how did you feel about the story arc between Marcy and Ice King when you first read the script?
I thought it was heartbreaking. I was also really excited, though, when I read it. I did not think the story was going to go there or be that deep, especially, you know, stemming from the first season where she didn't really have a whole lot of emotional backstory. So it's really cool. And I actually knew Tom Kenny since I was a little girl, so it was kind of this weird real life reflecting the show.
Thank you. And my second question will be, given that you just sang us your little tune from Steven Universe, seeing how the show is also on hiatus and has been confirmed for a third season, will we be expecting your voice gracing the SU anytime soon?
I didn't catch that last part. Could you, something season, and then.
Given that you did provide a song from Steven Universe, will we be expecting you to play a part in Steven Universe sometime in the near future.
Oh, I haven't done anything, but I would absolutely love to do it. I love the show, so yeah, maybe. Rebecca, are you listening too? Hi.
Thank you for your time.
Sure.
Hello, beautiful
Hi.
Ladies. I got a quick question. Other than the Small Town Steven Universe, Adventure Time, and Phineas and Ferb, what other shows did you play in?
I haven't done much other voice acting stuff, but back in the day, I was a little kid actor, and I was on Zoe 101.
Wait, Zoe 101? Oh, I watched that show.
I was on the Tracy Morgan show. I did the Ellen show, but it was like Ellen the musical, so I pretended to be a nerd. I don't know. If you really want me to be embarrassed, go Google the Ellen show nerd like me, and I'll die.
All right. Thank you for your time, ladies.
Hello.
Hi.
If you could, like, play a role in any other currently running animated series, what would it be, and which character would you pick to play?
I haven't thought about that. Currently animated. I don't know. I like Lewis from Family Guy. I love doing her voice. PETA!
thank you.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hi.
I think I just have a fairly simple request. Could you please sing Daddy, Why Did You Eat My Fries?
I need a beatbox. Where's Jeremy? Yeah. Daddy, why did you eat my fries? I bought them and they were mine. But you ate them, yeah, you ate my fries. And I cried, but you didn't see me cry. Daddy, do you even love me? Well, I wish you'd show it, 'cause I didn't know it. What kind of daddy eats his daughter's fries and doesn't even look her in the eyes? Daddy, there were tears there. If you saw them, would you even care? Ba-da-ba-da-ba. That wasn't really a simple question, but...
I thought it was. But thank you. You just made the whole convention for me.
Oh, thank you.
I know this is a really stupid question, but who did you play on Zoe 101?
Oh, I was just like, girl, four.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I was just in a few episodes doing, like, random banter with the group of girls.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay. Is that it?
That can't be it. Don't be shy.
Don't be shy.
Get up here and ask some questions.
I want to talk to you. Don't make me ask you guys questions, because I can't hear all that way. Okay.
Nobody else? I'll ask you questions.
Okay.
Okay. What cartoons did you watch growing up?
I was a huge Nickelodeon fan. I loved Rugrats and We're All Monsters and Hey Arnold. I loved Rocko's Modern Life, Ren and Stimpy. The classics.
I heard they're doing like a Toonami type situation with all the old Nickelodeon cartoons, or like bringing them back. That's happening though, right?
I think, I don't know if they're doing, I heard it was like a whole new network, but that might be not.
But with like old, I thought it was like a, I don't know. I'm excited though.
Hi again.
Hey.
So as a singer, who would you say is like inspirational to you? Who do you look up to as a singer?
As a singer?
If any.
Beyonce.
Oh.
No, not really. She is fabulous, but I really loved jazz music when I was growing up, because that's like what my parents would listen to. So I was always singing along to Billie Holiday and Aretha Franklin and stuff like that. More of like modern time singers. I really loved Amy Winehouse, RIP. And Christina Aguilera, she's got pipes.
Nice. And what about as a voice actress? Do you have anyone that you look up to as well?
Yeah, I think I look up to my older castmates. They've really taught me a lot about the voice acting world and given me really great advice and help, and have always been extremely caring and bestowing their knowledge upon me, that they've been doing it for, you know, 20-something years. So Tom Kenny, John DiMaggio, Hinden, they're all really great.
Awesome. Thanks.
Hello.
Hello.
Are you anything like Vanessa? Do you have any personalities?
Vanessa Doofenshmirtz? I think I'm a little happier than Vanessa. She seems to always be angsting. But I guess that's the goth way. I'm not much of a goth myself. I do wear a lot of black, but what did Doofenshmirtz call her style? It was like pilgrim demigoth or something like that.
Thank you.
Yeah, of course.
Hi, I ask this usually for any voice actor I ask questions for. What is your favorite cereal?
My favorite cereal?
Yes.
Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Thank you.
I like your tail, by the way. I didn't see that the last time.
So I have a couple questions. That was my friend. He just inspired me to ask you a question about food also.
Okay.
So one, what's your favorite type of muffin?
I was obsessed with poppy seed muffins when I was a little kid. There's like this one cafe my mom would take me to that I just would always get poppy seed. Yeah.
All right, thank you. Next.
Favorite type of muffin. I was not expecting that.
I watch a lot of YouTube, and there's this abridged series of Dragon Ball, and they say muffin button, so that's why I came up with muffin.
Fun fact about muffins. Have you ever been to, I think it's like muffintime.com or something like that, and there's like all these really weird short films about muffins. You should check it out.
I think my friend showed me that one.
There's one that's like this sketchy guy. He's like pretending to, it's like, basically he's like doing like a drug deal in the park, but it's with muffins. He's like, hey kids, want some muffins?
I might just check that just to confirm now. Now, I just ran across the whole convention just to watch my two sisters go on stage after everything, so I don't know what questions you've really been asked.
Okay, that's fine.
So I want to know if, not want to know. I would like to ask, what was your inspiration for voice acting and singing?
Well, I really didn't get into voice acting as of kind of like seeking it out. I did a lot of on-screen acting and singing when I was a kid. And singing for me always came extremely natural. Before I could even put sentences together, I was, you know, singing along with Barney and stuff like that. I just was inspired by different singers, I guess, but for voice acting, it was this whole new foreign thing to me that I was extremely lucky that Dan Palvenmeyer and Swampy Marsh, who created Phineas and Ferb, they're a close family friend of mine, and they really just helped me out by giving me that part because they wanted to help me with my singing career. And they said, you're not doing anything. You need to be like singing on TV, and we have a TV show, so here, be this character. So it was very scary and very new the first couple of times. Luckily for Vanessa, she's pretty straight-laced and kind of monotone, so that was kind of easy to play. But when I was cast as Marceline, she has so many emotions. She's up and down, and she fights other monsters and stuff, so it's really hard. But another thing about like voice acting is people sometimes think that you're just, you just kind of read the lines and they come out the way they do, but it's not the case. You have to like thrust your whole body into it. Like every time you hear like a yeah, like a punch noise, it's like we're punching the air like losers in the booth. So it's very physically daunting.
Interesting. Now, my last question is, since we are at a convention for comics and animation, you just stated what your favorite cartoons are. Do you have any favorite Japanese cartoons?
I haven't really got into the anime world yet, but I did watch Pokemon, if that counts.
Do you know what Pokemon you like?
Oh, my favorite Pokemon is Jigglypuff.
All right. Thank you.
Okay. So you're a really good singer and everything, and since Marceline writes songs, have you ever written a song?
Oh, I've been writing songs since I was like 7 years old. I love it.
Do you want to sing one for us?
I'll sing a little bit of a song, I guess, that I wrote. There's like hundreds, though, so I'm fanning my bank. Put me on the spot, people. Okay. I know this man who try hard as he cannot and will not be a one-woman man. Your little plan, it isn't working, I couldn't give a damn. But who do you think that you're trying to scam? 'Cause it's just a little bit suspicious when you never give me hugs or kisses. Do you give them to your other missus? I bet you do. Ooh, 'cause it's just a little bit suspicious. 'Cause you never held a common interest. I gave you love, you gave it to your mistress, so we are through.
I love you, by the way.
Thanks.
Yeah, my question is sort of similar. Were you ever in like a band growing up that I could like YouTube and see something hilarious or something? Not, no offense.
Oh no. Yeah, I've been in many bands throughout my angsty teenage years. I was in an all-girl rock band, and we were called Shock Value. And we thought we were extremely hardcore and wore a lot of eyeliner, but we were not that good.
Are you on YouTube?
I don't know if we have stuff on YouTube. YouTube wasn't really like hot like that back then.
Yes.
But maybe. I definitely was informed today by someone who was like, I love your songs on YouTube. I was like, oh, those are still up. So I do have like those old, you know, like vlogs of me singing my original songs when I was like 14. You could check out if you want me to be embarrassed.
Do you play guitar or something also or not?
I do. I'm not as strong on the guitar as I am on the piano. And I'm learning the bass.
Okay, awesome. Okay, thanks.
Hello.
Hi.
I was wondering if you had any favorite musicals.
Can you talk into the mic?
I was wondering if you had any favorite musicals.
Favorite what?
Musicals.
Musicals. Well, last night, I don't know if any of you guys were at the karaoke party, but me and this Babelicious Nutritious did a song from Rent, and it was a lot of fun. I love Rent. Wicked's really good. My friend actually was in, oh, I can't think of, oh, Book of Mormon. That's hilarious. Yeah.
So good. Thank you.
Hey, again.
Hi, again. So you act and sing, but can you dance?
Yeah, I was actually on my high school dance team, and we didn't really like our coach, so we all quit, and then we created the step team. Yeah, we also thought we were really cool and did like stomp the yard type like hip hop dancing, like literally like stepping, and it was interesting. But I love to dance. I haven't really been into it that much as I'm older, but
okay. And I noticed that you did one of your songs from your album, and I wanted to say that it was actually really good. I bought it when you were here last year.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah, but do you think you're going to probably be planning maybe to produce anything in the future? Or, like, what are your views or your thoughts about music in the future for you?
Yeah, I've been really busy with finishing up the book that was just put out, so that was kind of my focus for the last 6 months. But I want to go back and do more music because that's what I love. But I have a couple of songs, but I'm waiting until I could build up some more for like a full album, because that was produced extremely last minute, and we just did it to have something out there. And I want to put something out that I'm like very proud of, so it's going to take some time.
Okay. I actually have one more question, and it was actually about the book too. Is this your first time writing, and how did it feel to, you know, write a book, and just your thoughts about, you know, writing the book for Marceline?
It was crazy. I honestly don't know why Cartoon Network would like trust me to do that, right. But it's kind of funny that, you know, Adventure Time really has given me so many opportunities, and like I have to thank Penn for putting me on the show. But so I started out as an actor and a singer. My dad started out as a writer, and through Adventure Time, he became an actor and I became a writer. I always wrote music and music and stuff, but it was a really big challenge, but at the same time, it wasn't something that was necessary. He was actually gonna write the entire book. It was his book deal. And he would call me up. He was like, I'm so busy with the encyclopedia, or the, not the encyclopedia, the Enchiridion side. Like, I haven't even thought about the Marceline side yet. So when he started to write it, he would call me every 5 minutes asking me questions about Marceline. And then he goes, you know what, Liv? Just, can you do me a solid here and just, like, write some key things down and, like, I don't know, maybe write whatever comes to your mind because you know the character so well. And so he asked me for a couple of paragraphs, and I sent him like 30 pages. And he turned that in to Cartoon Network without telling them that it was me who wrote that. And he calls me, he goes, so I just got this email with like 6 pages of notes on the Enchiridion side, and they said, don't change a thing for the Marceline side. There's like a couple things to tweak, but like it's solid, keep writing it. He goes, well, I didn't write it. Olivia did, and they were like, what? And they were like so ready to like market that instantly. They're like, can she write the whole thing? Like, we didn't know that she wrote. Like, where did it come from? I felt like it was really easy to connect with the character, especially like I've seen all the episodes. I obviously was there when I recorded all of the Marceline ones, so it was pretty second nature. But we started gonna do Marceline's journal, like the one that you see in the Marceline's Closet episode. So I wrote every episode I was in from her perspective, and that's what I turned into them. But then we totally scratched that idea, and we really wanted to go with like the Simon backstory, because I think that's what the fans wanted. It's like, if we would have just done Marceline's journal, it would have been, okay, well, I already know what happened, and it's just kind of from her perspective. There wasn't a whole lot of room to really give a lot away. So I'm glad we did it this way.
Yeah, I think that's nice, too. And congratulations, too, on being able to write the book.
Thank you so much, Chelsea.
Yeah. Hi again.
Hey, I got a lot of questions.
Yes. I was wondering, I heard earlier that you're not very into anime now, but do you think you'd want to do any voice acting in anime?
Yeah, I'd be absolutely open to it. It's kind of weird, like, a lot of people that do anime voices kind of stay in the anime world, and like vice versa for, you know, Cartoon Network, Disney shows, stuff like that. Because the voice acting world that I'm in is already really, really small and hard to get into. And anime world is even smaller and harder to get into. So I haven't had any auditions for stuff, but I'd be open to it.
Well, there are a bunch of other animes that involve a lot of singing. So
yeah.
I'm sure you'd do great there.
Thank you. Maybe one day.
Hello?
Hello.
Well, you said you dance, you sing, do you do everything? Like, what's up?
I read minds, I can teleport.
Yeah, of course. But in all seriousness, what do you do to get ready for the voice acting for Marceline?
Well, I try to not scream for, like, if I know I have to be at work, I shouldn't be doing a whole lot of strenuous stuff on my voice. And I get sick extremely easily, so I'm very careful about my diet and, like, just making sure that I'm always washing my hands and stuff. But I think in the beginning of my voice acting career, I did a lot more just because I was trying to get into character and, you know, I would read the script religiously thinking I had to memorize it, and then I realized, oh, this is not on-screen acting. This is, you know, I can read it in the booth, so I'm okay. And it's so far gone now that I feel like I can just turn her character on like it's nothing. But definitely in the beginning was, you know, I would like dress like her. I mean, I still do sometimes like dress like her when I go in just to sort of get in that mode. But there's a lot of my personality in her, and I think that goes for any voice actor, you know.
And also, what do you do to get ready for any new voices?
I have such a hard time. It's now that I'm on this amazing hit show, I do get a lot more auditions kind of rolling through, but it can be pretty frustrating. I've actually like cried because I thought I was a terrible voice actor trying to like find voices for auditions. so just a lot of practice. It's kind of funny, I have all these character voices I could do, but majority of the auditions you get for are just like, the breakdown is like regular girl voice, but they're like, okay, but we don't want you to sound like you. And that's way harder. It's easy to do a character voice, but it's really hard to do a regular person's voice, but not make it sound like your voice. So that's very difficult.
Thank you.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
Hey, are we on? Right. Now, I overheard your answer to one of your questions about what kind of shows you watched growing up. And being a disciple of such cartoons, what do you think was your most favorite moment among those cartoons? Like, one of those moments that you'd rewind and watch all over again?
That's a very obscure question.
Yeah, personally for me, it involves the Rugrats in a projection room.
What part of the Rugrats?
The one where they go to the movies and they mess up the projection room.
Oh. Huh. You know, I always loved in Hey Arnold, or not Hey Arnold, in Doug, their band that they had. Banging on a trash can, driving on a streetlight. I always watch that on YouTube just because I like that song, even though it's like really weird.
It's really canny. But that's actually all I really wanted to know. Because it's not uncommon for me to watch these cartoons when I have nothing else to watch. Well, anyway.
Thanks for your question.
Welcome, man.
Hello. I had a question for you. So, like, in general for voice acting, you guys usually, like, have, like, emotions and stuff that go into the character. And in the beginning of Adventure Time, or closer to the beginning, Marceline,
can you talk a little closer to the mic?
Yeah, I can do that. So in the beginning of Adventure Time, Marceline had like a complex relationship with the other vampire, Ash. And I was wondering if you had any like kind of boy experiences that helped you like deal with that complex relationship that you had in the show.
Well, he's not a vampire, first of all, because she's the only one. But, oh, boys in general are stupid. So there was, right? Sorry, boys, but it's true. I had plenty of things to pull for inspiration.
Do you have any specific funny stories that you want to tell?
Well, my ex-boyfriend did get my best friend pregnant in the back seat of my car.
Classic.
And I'm not going to go into detail. That's all you need to know.
Yeah, that's good enough for me. Thank
yeah.
you.
I like your hat, by the way.
You wanted me to go there. I went there.
Okay. I didn't have to know that. Hi, big fan.
Hi.
The cartoon recent right now, what characters would you like to voice from the cartoons that have been released now? Like Regular Show, We Bare Bears, Gravity Falls. What characters would you like to voice in?
I don't know. I don't really think about that kind of stuff because it's like they're already the characters, but I would definitely love to be a Disney princess someday. That's like my ultimate goal. I want to be a Disney princess.
All right. What Disney princess would you like to be, actually?
Ariel.
Would you ever voice a comic book character like from Marvel or DC?
Oh, sure, yeah. I actually all the time get auditions for the new DC comics show that's out now, so I'm hoping that I book one of those.
Is there a specific character you want to voice?
Well, I auditioned for Supergirl. I auditioned for, like, I don't even know who it was. It was like some random person. But no, I like I said, I don't really like think about that. So no.
Okay. Thank you.
Hello, me again. just one question. As a musician, I also want to be sort of a musician myself one day.
Kate, is talking to the mic, please. It's hard for me to hear a little.
Is this good?
Yeah.
Good. Well, I want to be a musician one day, and I have an idea of how to do it, but how do you, like, get motivation, like, to write songs, like, write out lyrics?
Real life experiences, really. All of my songs that I write, you know, are 100% true to my own life. So you got to get out there, you know, date some people, go places, travel, like, that's the best thing I can do. The best inspiration is just, you know, your own life experience.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hey.
When you do the show and you eat something, are you guys actually eating something in the show?
No. Well, Marceline, she doesn't really eat anything. She just slurps the color out. And I don't think I've eaten anything as Vanessa, but I just go.
Thank you.
Hello again.
Hi.
So earlier you were asking, I asked if you watched anime, mm-hmm. and you said Pokemon. Would you have, and you said you might get into it if you maybe had a time, right?
Yeah. I mean, I got a lot of Netflix to watch, so whatever's out there.
If you don't mind ads, I suggest Crunchyroll, and there's this one anime that involves a lot of singing called Symphonogear.
Symphonogear?
Yeah.
Cool. Thanks.
So that's all I got to say. Just recommend it for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Is that all we got? No one else has anything? Any burning questions?
Don't be shy.
This girl has a burning question. Okay.
Okay, can you say the favorite line you've ever said? Like, your favorite one that you've ever said? Go.
Where are you? Oh, there you are. My broom!
Thank you.
All right, well.
We have plenty of time for more questions. Please don't be shy.
Are you moseying up or are you leaving me? Don't leave.
Don't leave. He's moseying.
Are you in contact with any of the other actors in Adventure Time?
Am I in contact with them?
Yeah, like, know them. Like.
Yes, I work with them once a week. Hi.
Hi. Hi, I have a question. I love you as Vanessa Doofenshmirtz on Phineas and Ferb.
Thank you.
excuse me, my voice. Do you have a favorite scene as Vanessa Doofenshmirtz on Phineas and Ferb?
Favorite scene? I really like the backyard rave episode where Doofenshmirtz becomes a rapper all of us, or a DJ slash rapper. I thought that was just so funny watching Dan, like, this old white guy, like, rapping and getting to just comment on that. Like, ugh. I felt embarrassed for him while he was doing it, so it was, like, really good and easy for me to, like, play an embarrassed daughter because I was like, you're embarrassing yourself, but this is great.
Can I ask you one more question?
Yeah.
What was it like singing with Ashley Tisdale? You know that song of the episode where Candace was being suspicious with Phineas and Ferb, and then, like, Vanessa being suspicious of her daughter, Doofenshmirtz. What was it like singing that song with Ashley Tisdale?
Well, we actually recorded it separately, so I didn't sing with her, but I was super excited when I got to hear the finished product and just knowing that I was going to sing with her. And just the fact that she's on the show that I'm on, like, I loved High School Musical, so, except I'm more of a Vanessa Hudgens girl myself, but she's bae.
Thank you.
I actually saw Vanessa Hudgens last weekend at New York Comic Con, and I didn't know what to do. Her and her hunky, hunky boyfriend, Austin Butler. I walked out of the bathroom, and they were getting escorted by, and I was just like, you're beautiful. And they looked at me like I was crazy, and I was like, I don't even care. Like, my goals are met.
Hi. I just got here, so I didn't know if anybody asked about Sadie's song.
Oh, Sadie, I sang it. You missed it.
I just wanted to know if it was like a different process than when you sing on Adventure Time. And
It was extremely similar because we all record in the same place for all the Cartoon Network shows. So it was kind of nice though, because I just went in and I got to do the song, and then I didn't have like 3 hours of lines to do. So it was pretty quick in and out, and I was so excited to get to work with Rebecca Sugar again because I missed her. Like, good for her that she has her own show, but like, I miss her writing my songs. That's what she's supposed to do.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hi. Cool shirt, by the way.
Thank you. If you can make a song with any artist, who would it be?
Ooh. Well, I did meet Donald Glover backstage at a concert and was like, I'm Marceline, you're Marshallie, and he said that we should do a song together, so I'm waiting because I keep like tweeting him. I'm like, okay, are we gonna do this? Maybe he was just like You love him?
love him.
I think it would be awesome to do like Marceline Marshallie mashup, Childish Gambino, you know? Hi.
I want to ask a question for both of you guys. What is your favorite line to say as your characters?
Oh, I'm not a character. I'm just her bodyguard.
Oh, sorry. You're late,
it's okay,
so.
But I'm a really big Princess Bubblegum fan. Oh, so,
okay. Do you have a favorite Bubblegum line?
Just everything she says. My favorite episode is everything she says in the episode where like Finn wears those glasses and like ruins her like science conference.
Oh, yeah.
That's like my favorite episode of all time.
I like when she speaks German. My favorite, I just said my favorite line, but I have multiple. It's over, you psycho!
Thank you.
I have another question.
Shoot.
Okay, so in the episode when Finn kind of like hides in Marceline's house, I know that voice actors kind of get like protective of their like the sanctity of their characters, I guess. Did you have any like objections to like the part where Marceline basically flashed Finn?
I thought it was kind of funny. Especially the fact that she like doesn't know she flashed him. Well, I guess she finds out later that she was in his house, but she really seemed fine with it. Like at the end of that episode, they're like, wait, so you're not mad? And she's like, no, I hide in your house all the time. Like, so Finn probably flashed her a couple of times.
All right, thank you.
I just wanted to say I really enjoyed the original song that you wrote yourself when you sang.
Oh, thank you.
Since I saw that there was a lack of people asking questions, I'd hate to do it, but I was wondering if you could possibly sing another one.
Sing another. Now I gotta rack my brain. Okay. Yeah. I got it. You and I have been through so many rounds. I know that you were feeling down and out. I'm still fighting, so give me one last shot tonight. I'm on the ropes and I know that you felt that I've been getting you, hitting you below the belt. I'm still fighting, so give me one last shot tonight. One more night.
Thank you very much.
Cut me off.
So excited.
If you could hang out with Marceline or Vanessa, who would it be?
Definitely Marceline. Maybe she'd let me like ride on her back while she flew around. Another one!
this time is from my friends. So all my friends are Disney fanatics, and they wanted to know if, I mean, they wanted to know what Disney movie you enjoyed.
Disney movie? Well, I mean, I love Frozen. Who doesn't? All the Disney princess movies, all the ones from the 90s. When I was growing up, I also like loved the Disney Channel original movies. I had a really big crush on famous Jet Jackson. So his movie I watched a million times over. I love all of the reboots they've been doing of the princess movies, like the Alice in Wonderland that they came out with. I just saw Cinderella, which was good. I like them all. Who doesn't like Disney movies? They're like the best movies there are.
Good point. Now, my last question would be, what's your favorite Disney voice actor?
Well, I did just meet Jasmine, and I fangirled and told her too much information about my childhood and my obsession for her. So, definitely her.
Okay, thank you.
I haven't met any other ones, so it's like, I'm going to go with the one that I know, or think I'm friends with now.
All right.
If Adventure Time was an anime, what kind of like anime would it be? Like chibi, gore, mystery?
Well, I just said that I haven't watched anime, so I don't really know. I guess it would be an adventure show. That's so lame, I know. I don't watch anime, and I haven't gotten into it yet, so.
From my opinion, I think.
Okay.
From my opinion, I think it would.
Don't yell at me.
Well, from my point of view, I think it will be an ad, like mixed with adventure and chibi. And well,
So what is chibi then?
It's like
inform cute, me.
Like, I don't know, like cute, like cute animations.
Oh, yeah, chibi is when the characters cute are like really little, like chubby versions of themselves. You know.
No. I'd like to see that because Marceline is so lanky that it would be nice to see her in a little squashed version.
Well, that was my question. Bye.
Thanks. Man, I can't believe I was just yelled at from the audience. That was aggressive, girlfriend.
She just has your best interest in mind.
Thank you.
All right, anybody else? Does anybody want to recommend some anime for her to watch?
Yeah, please do. Apparently I'm a horrible person.
Hi, I just want to say it's okay. You can watch whatever you want to watch as long as you enjoy it. It's okay if you're filled in a room filled with people who like anime. As long as you enjoy what you're watching, that's all right.
Thank you.
Yeah. And I also wanted to say I hope you have a nice day.
I'm into really like horrible girly TV shows about drama. That's
well,
just my
you
thing.
Like drama and girly stuff. You should watch anime, but if you don't necessarily like it, that's fine. But one anime I would recommend you attempt watching is Vampire Night. It is amazing. Although the ending to the English version is going to drive you like mentally insane. I send hundreds of dollars to China to try and fix the ending.
What's it called? Vampire
Night.
Vampire Night.
Yeah. I sent hundreds of dollars to China so I could get a cosplay, and my friends are going to do the same thing, and then we're probably going to like do something on YouTube.
Nice. Is that the cosplay you got?
Yeah, but pieces of it are missing now because they got lost at Supercon, but I'm going to fix that up.
Oh. Well, thank you
and
for
I
the
met,
suggestion.
And I met Vic Mignogna, who is the other lead in the anime. So.
Oh, cool.
You had mentioned someone recommend anime to you since apparently the audience thinks you should watch it. If you have Netflix piling up to add to your pile, there's an anime called Nana, or Nana, like N-A-N-A, that's on Netflix. It's a really big drama. Two girls around the age of 20 move to Tokyo. They don't know each other's name or anything, and they meet on the train. And one of them is a punk rocker
yeah.
in a band. You'd probably
yes.
love it.
Yeah, Nana's great.
Alana.
Okay, we got Lana, we got Symphonic, what? And then Vampire Night. Oh. Is this going to just be the anime suggestions yeah. now?
It's Nana, N-A-N-A.
Oh, Nana, okay.
Hi. You should watch Oran High School Host Club.
Thank you.
Hey, it's on Netflix.
I would suggest Tokyo Ghoul. It's what I'm dressed as.
Oh, I think my boyfriend watches that one. Thanks.
I'm actually not here to request anime. Don't feel bad. I'm not into it that much too yet. I mean, I want to get into it, but I don't have time. But I do want to request another song if that's cool.
Another what?
Another song.
Okay,
now from Adventure Time. Since you do say you like Disney movies, what's your favorite Disney princess song, and can you just sing it?
Well, I was telling Jasmine that, you know, A Whole New World was the only thing that would get me and my brother to not be arch enemies in our childhood, because we needed each other. So you want me to sing?
Yes.
Okay. I can show you. I'm sorry.
Come on, it's going on YouTube.
I can show you the world, shining, shimmering, splendid. Tell me, princess, now when did you last let your heart decide? I can open your eyes, take you wonder by wonder, over, sideways, and under a magic carpet ride, a whole new world.
Yeah. All right, and on that note, no pun intended, we are going to wrap this up.